Well, hello there. Welcome. Yeah. Unexpected. A return to LEGO Harry Potter, Wizarding World, with the. I don't know how to properly say it. Sorry, even for my tongue is being twisting. So, long story short, came out all of a sudden the remastered edition of the game, LEGO Harry Potter. It brought the formal unification of both parts, years 1 to 4 and years 4 from 5 to 7. Also, there were promised improved graphics, and the same time, most important thing which it brought is actually achievements. At the same time, shall see how things will go from technical side. Plenty of customers, players were, well, saying that at the very least Steam version is fulfilled with the technical issues. Never found such on a GOG version. At the same time, this remastered never appeared, at least by now, on GOG. There only appears on the original so-called vanilla one. So let's see. As for the Tiny Rogues previous one, which was on my Tuesday slot, well, it will be slightly postponed until the update which will bring the Abyss will come. As of now, I simply don't know what else to do there until the further progress will be available. I am yet to know what to do there. But with the addition of the further progress, I will know what to do. But by now, let's see, let's test how things will go with this one, remastered edition. Let's see if there anything actually better in terms of graphics, in terms of technical issues, etc., etc. Shall see by now, and what else to say? Let's go. Please enjoy this. All right, here we go. The remastered edition of like Harry Potter. Let's see. This will not load saves from original. Okay. New beginning then.
Huh?
Okay then. I'll slightly add to the brightness. Well, first thing I'd like to say, instantly recognize that's well. What you actually first see, that the sound, it actually was improved, like in a good way. There is now sounds like just like it if it was developed in 2024. So yeah, sound overall was improved. This I can say, this I can confirm. Should bother about the collecting of stats, knowing that there eventually will be multipliers. At the same time, nearest one, as far as I remember, will be coming only at at the year 3. Also, hood was fixed. From now on, it will be more comfortable to play. Slight performance issues. Okay. I suppose nothing more here to explore. Let's go further. I don't know. At the same time, if everything will be alright. Maybe I'll try to aim at 100%. Who knows how much time will be needed for Tiny Rogue's developer to finally incorporate the Abyss. Kinda interesting that somehow I still remember all of this, even though I played it for, I don't know, a year ago or so. Also nice detail that this bungee will break under Hagrid. To immersion most of mostly important of all. Well, I mean, if we have a Hagrid half giant twice as big as a normal human being. Well, and game simply shows how he is actually bigger. Well, this location is more bright than the vanilla one. Even more to say, this feels seemingly is redesigned. How could I miss? Also this. Okay, what else? Right. Good. Not good if I am using controller. As you can see, well, mouse pointer should be removed. But by the time when I'm using a controller, maybe it will be fixed eventually. That's not all. There should be two more. One is here. I missed this? Good. How exactly? Not only I like the fact that this location was redesigned, but how it was redesigned as well. Well, of course, there's tables at which goblins are sitting. Are visually outdated. Visually, I mean. But still. Overall light. I can't tell you this was improved. Okay, let's progress. Same time, the thing at which I am interested the most is was the pick of characters fixed for free play? There have to be something better than rather than this randomizer. To break this later, much later. Slight performance issues, but at the same time I had to take a look. Was it because of my rig currently looted or because of the game itself? Good. I'm not true wizard. Well, before I find the multiplier, I have to worry about amount of stats collected. Yep, that's all yours. Worry. Bless you. From movies, which never appeared in books.
Oh.
Okay. There have to be a red brick. Scabbers. So yeah, now instead of spells over the health bar or a character icon, we have it's under the character icon. Okay. Okay. Gryffindor boy. Oh, come on. Stop sleeping. Hello there. Okay, let's learn our first spell first. Yeah, overall lightning was improved in a good way. Thank you. Now I have to hold it for the spell to be successful. Some boy. Okay. Nice. I could only wonder if that's overall or for both parts or only touching one. Okay, now we know how to perform basic spell, which is nice. too dark. Yeah, the thing is the game being too dark can be unfortunately fixed. Okay, let's move further. Already spending way too much time.
Thank you.
Well, sorry for that. Kinda cold now. At the same time, I don't know what else to say. I like this spatula. Mario introduced here in this remastered edition. That's where you were hiding. Can't stop me. Thank you.
Okay. Now we'll collect multiplier afterwards. I will collect my true wizard. Okay, one story mission for this episode, and this will be it for today's episode. I don't want to do very lengthy episodes anymore. The lights here are better, but here we have a darkness. What is this?
Ha!
Why am I clipping through such obstacles? Am I stuck now or what? What is this? Come on. Huh? One of Snape's students, I suppose. Characters. Okay, maybe for the later. Still no achievement. Interesting. Okay. Well, performance issues, as this one could sometimes be strong. Okay. To a third and final story mission for today. At least I assume. Okay, maybe now to the story mission. Thank you. They even added some sound effects for waving flags. Okay. Well, sometimes the stats are looking weird. For someone it will be kind of difficult to know the difference between gold and silver ones. That's for example. They are looking so bleak. I only wonder what is the reason behind this. Maybe technical one. I guess this one can be done only in a free play. Because I need a character which could fly. The Bioshock. Invisible wall, nice. That was unfortunate. The student will be in peril because he simply can't murder, yeah? Yeah, invisible wall. Okay. Hey. Why would my character jump away while doing spell? It helped me a lot. Okay, and that's it for today. Let's move on to an outro.
Oh yes, that was an episode number one of me trying this remastered edition, and yeah, people were right, truth be told. There are technical issues, sometimes light could change just from moving to the very same location. Sometimes a game looks just way too bleak, there were glitches even. But I don't know. We shall see. At the same time, the thing which is worries me more, why I haven't got any of achievement. Uh-huh. Because now it's not the time. First one will be by completion of the story. So yeah, I will. I should eventually get it. Okay. There won't be achievements like collect 70,000 stats like in Lego Star Wars. So okay. Shall see during the next episode. I could only hope the state will be improved of this remaster, because these technical issues, well, not very visible. Well, they are actually visible, but I mean, they are present not in the very critical amount, but still are visible. That's what I meant to say. So I hope it will be fixed. Still work to do. And now simply wish you to stay strong, healthy, and to have a nice day.